big news of the day, just 2 minutes away. But first, Christmas in July. A Florida town has apologized for refusing to put a Christian nativity scene on public property, even though it was already displaying a Jewish menorah. The city settled a discrimination suit and agreed to pay all legal fees, but it still claims that it's done nothing wrong. Fox Report now from Orlando Salinas.
A federal judge says the ritzy town of Palm Beach, Florida, must recognize all religious symbols equally.
This town thumbed their nose at the law and the Constitution when their own legal opinion, which they hid from the public, indicated it would have been purely constitutionally permissible.
Four times the women offered to donate a nativity scene to be placed next to a Jewish menorah already on public property. Four times the town flat out ignored the women's request.
The town did not respond to the plaintiff's request as quickly as it perhaps should have. And from that standpoint, we apologized to the plaintiffs.
The town said a Christmas tree was a Christian symbol, so there was no need for a manger.
We see this across the nation as a discrimination against Christian symbols during the Christmas season.
The town has issued a public apology, hoping to put this PR nightmare behind it.
It created a great deal of acrimony in the town and a great deal of dissension.
Palm Beach says next Christmas all religious symbols will be placed inside one park together to avoid offending anyone. In Miami, Orlando Salinas, Fox News.
In the Culture War segment tonight, as you know, the ACLU and others want to ban pretty much any religious display from public property. We've reported on this time and time again. In Palm Beach, Florida, city officials refused to allow two citizens to donate Christian nativity scenes for Christmas displays, despite the fact Palm Beach is displaying the Jewish menorah on public property. Well, a federal judge has now ruled Palm Beach was wrong, and it has to pay $50,000 in attorney's fees and apologize to Maureen Donald, and Fern Dinnervaz. Joining us now from Southfield, Michigan, is Richard Thompson, the chief counsel of the Thomas More Law Center, which helped in this case.
What it's showing, Bill, is a hostility towards Christianity, as in the New York school system when they specifically said the Islamic star and crescent, the Jewish menorah can go up, but specifically said the Christian nativity scene could not go up.
But you're involved with that, too, right?
Yes, and the reason the judge said it was, well, there's a dominance of Christian displays out there,
right,
and let's have some kind of parity between Christians and
we'll
these other
religions. Yeah,
exclude
in the public school any kind of Christian.
Yes.
Well, Counselor, I hope you win up here. It's nice they won in Florida, and keep going. And if you want to get the Thomas More Law Center, go right on their website and help them out, because we need that counterweight to the ACLU. We appreciate it, as always.
Thanks.
Fox News Channel, America's newsroom.
Impact segment tonight, freedom of expression versus the right to regulate the conduct of students. This is a debate that's going on all over the USA. And at Denby High School in Newport News, Virginia, a 17-year-old senior was told he could not wear a sweatshirt that said, quote, abortion is homicide, unquote. The boy's father contacted the Thomas More Law Center, and a lawsuit was threatened. The school caved. Joining us now from Farmington Hills, Michigan, is Ed White, associate counsel at Thomas More. So you're like the ACLU of the right. In fact, a follow-up segment tonight, a fight back against the ACLU in Southern California. Hundreds of people showed up today to tell the L.A. Board of Supervisors they do not want to change the county seal. Both sides of the street were lined with demonstrators, and as we have been reporting, the ACLU is threatening to sue L.A. County if it does not remove the seal, which has been in place for 47 years and symbolizes the missionaries who settled in Southern California. Well, today the supervisors got an earful from angry Southern Californians, and we are very happy to see this, by the way. I think we generated a lot of it, because you guys got to get out there and fight this ACLU, or they're just going to take over the country. Joining us now from Ann Arbor, Michigan, is Robert Muse from the Thomas More Law Center, which has now entered the fray, as they say.
We're asking the court to declare first that the seal as adopted in 1957 is constitutional. We want them to declare that the policy that was adopted on June 1st to remove the seal and now reaffirmed today is unconstitutional, and we're going to seek an injunction to prevent them from removing the cross from the seal.
Well, good for you, Mr. Muse. Now, how can people get in touch with your organization if they want to help you out or if they need your help?
Yeah, our website is www.thomasmore.org, M-O-R-E, or they can contact us at 734-827-2001. Their support is obviously very well needed. The ACLU has a lot of funds and has a lot of support, and Christians need to stand up and fight against them, and we're there to do that for them.